in, which is a good thing. I'm seeing a lot of what looks like businesses on the left-hand side and the residential on the right. But beside the businesses and small businesses, there's actually a lot of occupants in these places, which, you know, that's good. That's a good thing. So my roommate told me, Dejan, not a smart dude, told me that yesterday, Best Buy actually had a 5% increase in their gross. I mean, 5% increase for the last quarter. That's, I'm telling you, we're bad. Things are bad, but the things that have been done so far are helping, because it looks like we're starting to. It's like the economy right now is, it's like a race car that's skidding on the track. We just need to make it around and get to the pit. So now we're in the pit now, and we're changing the tires. Obviously, you have to warm the new tires up, and I think that's what we're doing now. Eventually, it's going to take off, and Americans will do what Americans do. Spend, waste, and all that. Because, you see that? That's how accidents take place right there. The truck boy had to blow his horn. I know you guys didn't hear that, but, you know, there's people like, it's like they're daydreaming. It's like the living dead. But anyway, what I think Obama should do as far as the people underneath him in his cabinet, I think that he shouldn't have any one person in charge of any one thing. And this is my reason. If he has one person in charge of, I'm going to use Geithner, seeing that he's pretty much in the limelight all the time. Geithner, and he's probably a smart dude, very smart, in an Ivy League training school, and you know, he was big in New York and in the stocks and all that. I mean, it seems like a smart dude. I mean, obviously, if I don't know, he can say whatever he wants to say, and I'm going to believe him. But the thing is, he doesn't have the trust of the people yet. People trust Obama, and since Obama bring him in, or you know, is using him as his front man, then automatically some of the trust we have in him is through Obama. What I think he should do instead of that is he should make a few positions where instead of one person, you make it three people, preferably a Democrat. One Democrat, one Republican, and I don't know, maybe a Nobel Peace Prize winner, or, you know, who's somewhat in the middle, even if he's on either side, a Nobel Peace Prize winner, or somebody who's respected in that respective industry. Now, whenever decisions need to be made, everybody reports to these three, and then whenever something needs to be, I mean, obviously it has to be signed off by the press. So, but what that will do is that'll take a lot of the stuff, a lot of the weaning out and the fishing, trying to find out what to do and where to go and all that stuff. It'll take a lot of stuff out, and it'll rest it on their shoulders to kind of work it out before it gets to the president. Now, obviously, when it comes to the math, you have to show the math working out from the beginning, so they're going to have to show the press everything from the beginning onwards to where they get to that decision. But if you have a Nobel Peace Prize winner there who, you know, more than likely is going to be, have a good sense of direction when it comes to certain things. He may not know everything, but he won't know everything, even in his own respective genre. But the good thing is he'll have a good sense of what's going on. And I think that's the way you should do it. Hear the bob. Some say it's just a part of it. We got to fulfill the book. The song of freedom is all I ever had. I know me can't sing, but what I gotta do? And you know what? The question I need to ask myself is, if I wasn't recording it, would my voice sound better? Of course. You don't know that? Reaching to work at 11 o'clock. If you guys watched the one before, the one that I used to when I was at my deployment last night, on the way home from the deployment. Yeah, I was at work last night till about 1 o'clock. So, cool thing about Carnival is they give me enough leeway to do my work. And they will reward you, man. Other places may get respect about by bodies of people and all that crap. Carnival gets my respect because they respect you as a person. Like everywhere else, you know, crap goes on, but Carnival gets my respect. Ever had redemption songs? Now we're in Miami. Nice little drive to work, you know. Here, if you can't speak Spanish, not really much of a future when it comes to certain. It comes to certain areas or expertise or working with certain companies. That's definitely a plus. The bigger you go, the more it doesn't really matter, but you know, if you're in the middle, then better break out the Rosetta Stone, which is a very good app, by the way. Alright, now if you can see the sign, good, but we're going to Southwest or Northwest 36th Street. Right on the corner. Alright, listen to this opening. This opening is one of the wickedest openings in any CD. Only Stone Love have opening like this.
So you can point your fucking fingers. I said, that's the bad guy, baby. Thank you.